being acted out in healing on the other hand. And so you have growth that's binding and loosening motif, not only at the level of binding.
You're now going to switch to another kind of grace, which I'm going to call the grace of empathy.
Yeah. One more thing about that liberation. He liberates that whole community from a culture of shame. Like, they're all, there's a community that the young lady talks about that.
Yeah.
Who's really raped, and you see her face.
The whole community has been shamed. In fact, the whole community is being terrorized.
Yeah, by their own members.
And that external, or that evil has been lifted.
They're not their own members. They're different tribes that came over.
Actually, the boy, the leader, he's actually her cousin.
Yeah. Was the last word that Clint Eastwood speaks, grace? Hail Mary, full of grace.
Yeah.
Was that the last word?
Yeah, it's Hail Mary, full of grace. That's the last word spoken is the word grace, which I take it to mean that I'm not hallucinating about all this stuff. You know, these films actually do have something to do with grace. Okay, now I'm going to call the last form of grace we look at the grace of empathy. Those surprising, serendipitous moments in which folk who ordinarily don't understand or like each other suddenly find mutuality and commonality, and in fact, point of view.
I'm preachers who find it helpful. I will tell you, where's John? Where's Father John? You'll appreciate this, John. I take my mother to Mass every 8 weeks because she can't go on her own. She's 94. And twice, after her new priest came, I was sitting there in the first row where she always wants to sit, facing him, about like this, and he preached sermon seats both times. I thought, well, isn't that interesting? He's using the same illustration that I write. Well, isn't that interesting? He's quoting the same sculpt. Isn't that interesting? He's using my ending. And it dawned on me that while women cannot preach in Catholic churches, we can infiltrate the pulpit.